Make this simple outline animation in After Effects. So first we need to add a shape. You can do it by going to the top left and then click and hold on the shape icon and then choose a shape. Now click and drag on the screen to create a shape. Now if you want to create a symmetrical shape, then you can hold shift by dragging. And if you want to, you can also align the shape using the align tab. You can also disable the fill option by going to the top and then hold alt by clicking on this little box in order to cycle through the different options and then switch to the disabled option. Now expand your shape layer and then click on add and then select trim path. This will add this trim path option to a layer. Now expand the trim path section, then keyframe start. And also make sure to set the value to 100. Your shape should now be hidden. Now move forward a bit and then set the start value to 0 and we should see your shape again. We have now created this animation. And also don't forget to select both keyframes and press F9 to make the animation more smooth. Now if you want, you can also tweak the animation further by going to the graph editor and then simply playing around with the curve. We are now done with the starting part of the animation. Now there are two different ways to animate the ending part. So the first way is to move the player where I want the end animation to start, and then click on the arrow next to start to create a keyframe for the current value. Now move forward where I want the animation to end, and then set the start value to 100. And we should now have created this nice animation. Now you probably noticed that the end and the start animation went in the same direction. And you might like this, but I'm going to show you a different way to do this. So keyframe end where I want to start the end animation, then move forward and then set the end value to 0. And also don't forget to ease the keyframes. You can also change the part where the animation starts and ends by changing the offset values. And if you didn't know already, the first value with the X behind it is the number of full rotations. The second one is simply how many degrees you offset the animation. Now you can get a little bit advanced by changing the offset value during the animation. So what I like to do is to keyframe offset a few frames after the first keyframe, then moving a few frames before the second keyframe and changing the offset value to a -1. And of course also make sure to ease them. We have now created this nice offset animation. And you can of course also do the same thing with the end animation. To create a keyframe for the current value a bit after the third keyframe, then move a few frames before the fourth keyframe and then simply lower the offset value even more. And we end up with this nice animation. Subscribe!